Hey guys, just wanted to talk today a little bit about some things just that sent me a lump. So yesterday I went to a therapy group and we talked about just like the causes of some of our issues and things like that happen. And one of those things being the things that you've done in your past can end up causing more issues for you in the future. So, you know, I've done a lot of horrible things in my past. I won't deny that. I've done a lot of terrible things to people. Said a lot of things that I didn't mean. I'm human. I know that a lot of people have done that, and I'm really one of those people that is the most hardest on myself. I tend to beat myself up for years and years to come, and that's one of the reasons why my issues come on, is because I'm still beating myself up decades later. You know, I'm still beating myself up for things that I did when I was a kid, or things that happened, you know, when I was a teenager, and I shouldn't be, because, you know, we should all be able to forgive ourselves. We should all have that ability to finally free ourselves from all of that, and it's been kind of a difficult road, but I really enjoyed being able to talk about that yesterday, because my therapist, our therapist for the group, was talking about how, you know, would you say those things to someone else who's dealing with the same issue? So, like, the things that, you know, the voices say, or things that have happened to us, or the things that we say to ourselves, I guess. Pretty much, would you say those things to someone else who's dealing with the same issues? And I know some people probably would, no doubt about it. But I think for the most part, people can recognize that they're usually nicer to other people than they are to themselves. And that is one of the biggest things. And here's the greatest part too. I feel like our thinking is more opinion-based than factual. And so when you start to realize that that's just an opinion, that's not a fact, that you may then realize that, you know, there's a lot of different opinions out there, and that's not the truth. It's not the truth that you're stupid, or that you suck, or that you're a loser, or that you are a horrible person. You know, those things aren't true. I'm working on grounding myself. I've been doing meditation every night, and I'm working on doing affirmations, loving myself, just like, you know, saying in the mirror, I love you, you're amazing, you're wonderful, maybe even using I am affirmations. I am wonderful, I am amazing. Those things can really help. Especially if you stare at yourself in the mirror, can really get to you that is the truth about yourself. I've had a lot of anxiety lately because I've been having a lot of issues over the past week. Sorry, breathing. Gotta take deep breaths. So I've been trying to make sure, that I'm doing everything I can to take care of myself. I have decided that I'm not going to even drink a little bit anymore. I kind of, for the holidays, was drinking a little bit. I would have like a beer or two when I would go out, not really get too wasted anymore. I try not to drink too much anymore at all, because it can really have a bad effect on mental health, or just on you in general. So I've been trying to work harder on making sure I stay healthy. And I think I'm going to stop drinking altogether for at least maybe a year or two. I say a year or two. I think I'm going to try for 6 months first. And then if I can do that, then I'm going to try for a year. But I think that it's okay to have like a glass of wine here and there. So I'm probably going to do something simple if I do anything at all, but I am going to try for a good while, 6 months at least, to not drink at all. But it's not bad to have like a glass of wine here and there. It's when it starts to affect you majorly that it's probably a good idea to stop. I mean, obviously. Yeah, sorry, my anxiety is really high, so I'm trying to, it's just been that way for a while now, just dealing with stuff, so, and, I am, working on my book still. There's gonna be some major changes done to my book. I actually am going to probably do some reorganizing and just, like, overhauls of the book. So it's probably going to take a little bit longer for it to come out, which is definitely something, but I definitely am hoping that, you know, because I have a lot of people that want to buy the book so far, which is great. I'm hoping, looking forward to reading it, and, I'm just looking forward to it coming out, but it's definitely going to take a little bit longer than I thought, and I am actually going to stop doing the pre-copies online, because there's going to be some major changes, and some people probably don't want to buy two different books, so anyways. That's my story for today. I haven't really posted a video in a little while. It was just me talking, so I thought I'd post one. Let you guys be updated on life. And I also wanted to use my own experiences, what I'm dealing with right now, as a way to help other people. So don't beat yourselves up. We all make mistakes, and I promise you, the people who, if there are people who are beating you up outside of you, those people have probably made just as bad of mistakes, if not worse. And they probably are still making those mistakes, even by just doing these things to you. And on the subject of beating yourself up, we all have moments of doing things based out of how we feel. We all do that. Every single one of us has a moment where it feels right to do that thing. It feels like the right thing to do in that moment. It feels like that's the only thing you should have done. And then you realize, you know, hindsight, that maybe it wasn't that great of a thing to do. You know what I mean? Like, maybe there was another action I could have taken, but in the moment, this was the only action I could see. So what do I do now? Now that I can't take back what has happened, you can't do anything but move on. And that is the most helpful thing to do, is to just move on. And I'm working on it too. I'm working on moving on, getting there, getting to a place where I can feel strong enough and loving enough to be who I was again, or be who I am, not who I was, because I don't want to be the person in the past, I want to be the person in the future. And that's the goddamn truth. So anyways, that's what I wanted to do, just talk about that to help people today. And I just, I feel like if anyone has any any issues that they need to talk about, I would be here for you. Like, I know I have some fans on here, and I know that everybody deals with their own stuff, so I would love it for if you guys have anything that you need to talk about, comment. Send me a direct message. I know I have a way that you can send me direct messages on here, if that's still an option, if they still allow that. I think they do. Just talk, and I will be here for you. I will be an ear to listen, or even a word of advice for you. Just send me a message. All right, I want you all to know that, yeah, well, I am not in the best of places, so of course I'm not like super perfect at this video, and I'll probably beat myself up over it, but I want people to understand that I am dealing with stuff, and I'm working through it. I'm working on it. I'm going to therapy. I'm going to group therapy. I'm taking medicine. I'm dealing with it how I need to deal with it, and I'm working really hard at bettering myself, and I am an amazing person, so I don't really want to hear anybody else's, stories about what I am to them, unless it's good. So, forgot to say something else in my last video, just to kind of add this in. You can only determine what you've done wrong. And I want you guys to acknowledge that, because somebody else could tell you, oh, you've done a million things wrong in your life, but who are they to say that? Only you can determine what you've done wrong, and they should be focusing on themselves as much as you should be focusing on yourself. You should not be out there going around telling people, you've done this wrong, you've done this wrong, you've done me wrong. You know, you can't go around doing that to everyone. Sometimes you have to focus on what your action was that maybe got you to that point that you were in the wrong. You know, you yourself were in the wrong, not them. And then when you can acknowledge that you've done wrong, then you can acknowledge, well, maybe we both weren't perfect. Maybe we both did not do the right thing. And maybe, just maybe, I can move on from this. Because you can't sit there and say, you've done wrong. You can't go up to them and be like, you did this wrong. You know what I mean? Like, at that point, you're not being self-aware. You're being just a person who wants to make sure everyone knows that they've done you wrong. You know what I mean? Like, at that point, you just have to be self-aware of what exactly you did. And then also be aware that you're not perfect, but nor are they. But then leave it alone. Because at that point, that's all that matters, is that you acknowledged what really happened. You saw it from both their side and your own side. And you moved on with life. There are some things that people do that you'll never understand, never be able to understand. But for us to go around telling someone that they're wrong for their actions, and I've done it before, I'm not gonna lie. I've told people, you're wrong for doing that. You're so wrong. It doesn't get me anywhere. It hasn't gotten me anywhere. Most of the time people are like, whatever. Or some of the times they're like, oh no, I feel so bad. You know, like sometimes they do actually feel bad. You can let someone know how something made you feel, but to beat them up for how they made you feel, isn't that just doing the same thing? You can let someone know, hey, that hurt me. You know what I mean? You can let someone know that. But sitting there and telling them, you are so wrong for that. You are just a wrong person, you horrible person for doing these things to me. It's not going to get you anywhere, is it? So, you were wrong, right? You need to be aware of your own wrong. And that's it. Just stay in your peaceful place. Try to remember that the world is not perfect. And I mean, hey, you're welcome to do whatever you want. If you want to go around telling people that they're wrong and that they're horrible people, that's fine. That's definitely an option of life. You can do whatever the hell you want. Just make sure it doesn't get out of hand, because I know sometimes it can get out of hand, especially when someone fights back. I'm not a horrible person. You just took it the wrong way. You know what I mean? Like when they start to fight back, you just took it the wrong way. Oh, now I'm about to beat your ass for that, right? No, I did not take it the wrong way. You are just a wrong person, and you know, and just fighting back and forth, fighting. Nothing really coming of it, but a nice beat down, right? Well, I definitely think that that's not helpful. So I choose, and you know, like I said, I'm not perfect. I've done it in my past where I said, you know, I've fought back, fought with them, had fights with them, told them that they were wrong. You know, I've done these things. But I choose now to stay in my peaceful place. Because, I mean, even though there have been some severe things that have happened to me that people have done to me, there's no way that I can make them feel sorry for those things. I can let them know that it hurt me. But sometimes even letting them know that it hurts you just makes you look like a weaker person to them. And what do you do at that point? So, some things that have happened to me, I have not announced to the world. Because I don't know how people, or I haven't announced it to those people. Because I don't think that they are deserving of that knowledge, that it hurt me. They don't deserve to know that that hurt me. And that's just it. I know I keep saying that, right? Alright, so I am going to let it go at that. I think that is good enough. So I am going to end it on this. Stay beautiful, stay wonderful, stay unique, stay you. Just stay peace. Peace. Namaste, right? And what does namaste mean? Anybody know? No, I do. It means the light in me sees the light in you. That's right. The light in me sees the light in you. Namaste. Peace. Love, guys.